how to add background music or sound effects to your video project by using two layers of audio in Shotcut. Let's get started.
So to demonstrate this, I have first of all created a new project, added a talking head video into my project, along with a soundtrack, and then four different sound effects as well. The first thing I'm going to do is drag in to the timeline the main project file. As you can see, as we scrub through, this is all setup time, so I'm going to cut just about here using the S and remove the beginning part of that file. Now, this is David. His name's David Yeabsley, and he has a channel all about future-proofing yourself. If that interests you, then I'll leave a link in the description below. He's given me permission today to use his footage so I can demonstrate using his voice rather than my own. Now, let me play the first few seconds and you'll hear exactly how it sounds.
In this video, we're going to discuss a wonderful topic about how to create your own luck.
As you can tell, the sound quality is reasonable and we don't need to make any more audio edits to that file. Now, there is another situation here where you have recorded your audio separately to your video. If that's the case, then you will need to import two files, your audio and your video, and then it will end up looking something like this. By the time you've matched them up, you'll have your audio file and your video file on different layers. It doesn't really matter which way you do it, but they are the two scenarios that you could have at this point. Now, the next thing we want to do is add an additional audio layer. It doesn't matter which order audio layers position themselves in because all of the sound plays equally. So let's add another audio track by clicking on timeline menu, track operations, add audio track. As you can see, that generates A2 in my case. If you have your talking head video and your audio on the same track, then you'll only have one audio layer at this point, and that's absolutely fine. This track is now ready for us to add our music into. So this is my music file. I'm just going to drag that into the A2 track. Now we've got our video, our person speaking, and our music all in the timeline. When we play that,
we could be here for hours, but no, this is only
you can tell that the audio is way too high. We don't want the audio to be causing a problem with the voice. The voice is the number one important thing that needs to be conveyed over the top of any other sound effects or music. So let's reduce the sound here. I recommend dedicating this track in Shotcut to this particular sound file. So with that in mind, I would then recommend using the filter on the track and not the individual clip. So click onto the track, so it's got a red outline, come up to filters, click on the plus, and then search for gain. Click onto gain and volume, and now we can lower the volume levels of the music. Let's try that once more.
About how to create your own luck. We could be here for hours, but no, this is only a...
And as you can tell, that now sounds much better. One thing to be aware of with music tracks is they generally finish before the person has finished speaking. So as you scroll along, it will stop, so there'll be no more music on here, but obviously the video carries on playing on the talking head video. So you may be happy with it fading off and not having any more music, or you may want to copy your audio track, setting your playhead here and then pasting. Now you can see that the music will play to the end because it will repeat that once. Once it gets to here, you also want to cut it off with the snip tool. So you can remove any excess audio. So there's a few options there. It's obviously your choice on what you want to do for your project.
Now, just before we continue, if we're meeting for the very first time, then my name is Joe and this channel helps YouTubers edit their videos and use free software. If you're creating YouTube videos regularly and not seeing the growth you'd hope for, you're probably missing one or more elements of the video creator framework. You can download the free PDF in the description below to get started. Now, let's get back to the video.
Now, let's come back to the start of the video file and consider how we may add some sound effects on top of what we've already created. The first thing I would suggest is using a new audio track for any sound effects. So our A3 track will now be our sound effects track. I've already found a couple of sound effects, so I'm going to push them onto that timeline now. And let's just use these two as an example. And now as we play...
That's a wonderful topic about how to create your own luck. We could be here for hours, but no, this is only a short video. I'm David.
Okay, so now you've added the sound effects into your project as well. I realise that I have not positioned those sound effects in very good places at all. This is just a demonstration, so you'd usually use sound effects in conjunction with your video pop-ups or things that are happening on screen at the same time. Again, that's entirely up to you how you do that, but this is how you would add sound effects and music into your video projects. Now for the video, I recommended adding a filter for the whole track. When you're using sound effects, every sound effect that you download and use or create is likely to have a different volume. So you're probably going to need to select the individual clip, apply the gain filter to each clip kind of manually. Now, if you use the same clip twice, then you can set it all up once and then click here to copy and then paste it onto any other clips that you want the same settings. So that can be some time saving, but you probably will need to do each one manually because you want it to align nicely with the volume of the person speaking and not to either be too quiet or too loud. The last thing to note with audio is that you also need to have the correct license for using that audio. I have used in this project YouTube's library. YouTube's library is free to use and you can use whichever clips and sound effects that you want. So your other options for that is to go and source elsewhere or to sign up to a subscription service that actually gives you the license to use the audio clips. That's generally a reoccurring monthly subscription, and if you stop at any point, then you may get issues from stopping that service. So just be aware of the impact that that kind of thing can have. Otherwise, you should be good to go for adding background music and sound effects into your projects.
Please consider liking and subscribing, and before you go, click or tap on the video on your screen right now, and it will continue to help you with Shotcut. I'll see you in the next video.